again, please.
I will give to you in dark times when no one wants to. I will give you me and we'll be us. All I have, I will give to you.
Good evening, everyone. You may all be seated. Well, my name is Philip, friend of the bride and groom, and I'll be the officiant for today's ceremony. Before we start, I am to remind you that the couple has requested this be an unplugged ceremony. So please silence and put away all electronics, photos, social media, and Pokemon. They'll be welcome at the reception. Thank you. Welcome, family and friends and loved ones. We are gathered here today, surrounded by crashing waves and caressed by the sea breeze, to celebrate the wedding of Isabel and Daniel. All of you are present today because you, in one way or another, have been a part of Isabel's or Daniel's life. They have known most of you for many years. You've watched them grow up. You went to school with them and you work with them and have forged bonds and friendships with them. Because you are the ones who have supported them and known them so well, it's only fitting that you are the ones to share this once-in-a-lifetime moment with them. Our bride and groom are truly honored that you, their dearest friends and family, have traveled from so far, or even from across town, to help them celebrate their love and commitment to each other. They would like to particularly thank their parents today for the unconditional love, support, and guidance you have always shown to them. Dan, Izzy.
What's up?
This marriage does not mark the beginning of a new relationship for you. Rather, it is an acknowledgement and a celebration of the love and life you share together. You are here to affirm the choice you make every day to stand together as partners and to love each other wholly. At this time, the bride and groom have personal vows to read to one another.
I start to choke when I try to find the right words to say, but all these things in my head, these reasons of mine, they still need to be said. I apologize if this seems last minute, but sometimes I can't stop myself from procrastinating.
No, you can't.
Izzy, this wedding may not turn out to be exactly what you wanted, depending on the weather, but this is better than a dream for me. All these things we've done together, from gaming to obstacle course races, the memories we've made, they lift me up. Sometimes I have to stop and stare because the words just won't come.
Oh my.
I won't stop loving you through all of the good and the bad, all the bad. We've been through so much and there's so much more to come. We'll just keep marching on though, no matter what comes our way. If I lose myself, it will be because I lost myself in us, with you. Since I met you, I've come out of a pretty dark place. You helped me feel again, and I feel that all this time together has been building to this moment. From the time we're waking up in the morning, to the time you come home, to the time when we finally go to sleep, there's nowhere I'd rather be than with you. No one else I'd rather share my secrets with. At the end of our road together, whenever that may come, I feel that I will be able to honestly say that I lived a good life with you. Our future looks good, and I have no fear that we'll be making some of the best memories of our lives. All we are going to accomplish will be accomplished together. I'm honestly amazed that I get to be with someone who seems to have all the right moves. I didn't realize that I'd found something I need. And if you think as I do that I was made for you, then there's no limit to where we can go together. So don't look down, don't look back, and let's light it up.
I see what you did there. Though, like, oh my God. There were so many One Republic song titles in there. Like, I can't. The puns were amazing, sir. I'm sorry, back to business. But you're a trouble leader.
Slick.
Well, how do I top that? It's been 4 years since we gave our love a chance. Well, 4 years, 2 months, and 20 days, but who's counting? The amount of days we've been together don't matter nearly as much of the as the content of said days. It has been 1,542 days of midnight beach runs and long nighttime drives to nowhere. Rushed breakfast first thing in the morning before work and off-key sing-alongs on the way home until we're wiped out. It has been your first convention, my first trip to Maine, and our first mud run. Two graduations, one awesome dog, and endless nights of record playing and tea sipping, talking about the worst parts of our past and the best parts of our future. In all those days, you've never failed to cheer me on as I approach my goals. You have always managed to listen to understand rather than to reply. You have respected my faith, supported my creative endeavors, and encouraged me to remain open and vulnerable. In 1,542 days, you have loved me for all of my faults and shortcomings. Despite how much I do not love myself, and have not yet had a single day in which you failed to tell me so. And for this, I thank you. I'm eternally grateful. Thank you for your boundless patience with my bad days, for the love and compassion on my better days, and for believing in me and in us from day one. I hope with all my soul, I know how much I love you, baby. And promise to do all I can to show you every day until my last breath. Here's to the last 4 years and to countless more.
Very beautiful. Dan, Izzy, you fell in love by chance. But you're here today because you're making a choice. You're both choosing each other. You've chosen to be with someone who enhances you, who makes you think, makes you smile, and makes every day brighter. You're about to make promises to each other that you intend to keep. You're going to vow to take care of each other, to stand up for one another, and find happiness in the other. There's a simple premise to each of these promises. You're vowing to be there. You're teaming up and saying to the other, every experience I'm going to have, I want you to be part of. Do you, Daniel, promise to be a loving friend and partner in marriage, to talk and to listen, to trust and appreciate, to respect and cherish Isabel's uniqueness? Do you promise to support, comfort, and strengthen her through life's joys and sorrows? Do you promise to share hopes and dreams as you build your lives together and to grow with Isabel in mind? Will you strive to build a home that is compassionate to all, full of respect and honor, filled with peace, happiness, and love? Do you promise to always be open and honest with Isabel and cherish her for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Pardon me. Do you, Isabel, promise to be a loving friend and partner in marriage, to talk to and to listen, to trust and appreciate, to respect and cherish Daniel's uniqueness? Do you promise to support, comfort, and strengthen him through life's joys and sorrows? Do you promise to share hopes and dreams as you build your lives together and to grow with Daniel and mine? Will you strive to build a home that is compassionate to all, full of respect and honor, filled with peace, happiness, and love? Do you promise to always be open and honest with Daniel and cherish him for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
To all of our friends and family, please stand. Please affirm your support by responding, "We will."
We will.
It means all of you. Yeah. Will you surround this couple in love, offering them the joys of your friendship? Will you support this couple in their relationship? At times of conflict, will you offer them strength in your wisest counsel and the comfort of your thoughtful concern? At times of joy, will you celebrate with them, nourishing their love for one another? You may be seated. At this time, I'd like to draw to your attention to the wooden box beside Izzy and Dan. In this box is a bottle of wine, bottled in 2013, the year of their relationship first beginning. In their hand is a love letter to their new spouse. The letters describe the good qualities they find in one another, the reasons they fell in love, and their reasons for choosing to marry. The letters are sealed in individual envelopes, and they have not seen what the other has written. Should Izzy and Dan ever find their marriage facing hardships, they will open this box, sit and drink wine together, then read the letters they wrote to one another to be reminded of the reasons why they are together. The hope is, however, that Izzy and Dan will never have a reason to open this box. And if this is the case, they are to open this box to share and enjoy on their fifth year wedding anniversary, replenish and open on their 10th anniversary, and so on. Izzy and Dan, you may now seal the box. It's starting to rain out here. I will now ask you to seal the vows you share with each other by the giving and receiving of rings. The perfect circle of the ring symbolizes eternity. The precious metal came from the ground as a rough ore and was heated and purified, shaped and polished. Something beautiful was made from raw elements. Love is like that. It comes from humble beginnings made by imperfect beings. It is the process of making something beautiful where there was once nothing at all. Dan, please take Isabel's ring, place it on her finger, and repeat after me. Isabel?
Isabel.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol.
As a symbol.
That I choose you.
That I choose you.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
My partner.
My partner.
And my best friend.
And my best friend.
Today.
Today.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And always.
And always.
Wear it.
Wear it.
Ooh. Think of me.
Think of me.
And know that I love you.
And know that I love you.
Isabel, please take Daniel's ring, place it on his finger, and repeat after me. Daniel.
Daniel.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol that I choose you.
As a symbol that I choose you.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
My partner.
My partner.
And my best friend.
And my best friend.
Today.
Today.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And always.
And always.
Wear it.
Wear it.
Think of me.
Think of me.
And know that I love you.
And know that I love you.
Isabel and Daniel, in the presence of your family and friends who have joined you to share this moment of joy, you have declared your deep love and affection for each other. You have stated your wish to live together, always open to a deeper, richer friendship and partnership. You have formed your own union based on respect and honor. Therefore, by the power invested in me by the state of Florida and by the internet, it is my great pleasure to renounce you, husband and wife, partners for life. You have formed your own union based on respect and honor, once again. You may now kiss each other. Now, if you'll all stand, it is my pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Daniel Bryan.
Shall we?
Well, I'll be out of the rain soon.